I was actually born in Chicago, but we were living then in a small town, Glen Ellen. You've heard of it. I think now it's quite a big town. It was a very tiny little suburb then. And my mother was a school teacher, principal, assistant principal in a school in Chicago. She came and went every day to her school. My father was a tailor. He was an apprentice to German tailors. And he had a lot of that Germanic attitude toward discipline that he must have gotten from these people that he was apprenticed to. He was very successful in his business, and my mother's death when I was three, I think, was a great shock to him. He's a very young man. He was, I believe, 21, and she in her 30s when they married. So,
was she? I believe I read somewhere that she was French Canadian, or
yes, she was French Canadian, and when she died, my father then gave up his ambitions to establish something in Glen Ellen or Chicago, and began touring as a traveling tailor. I think that he left us. My brother was 6 years older than I.
Albert.
And yes, Albert. We stayed with relatives, and until my father came back and brought a new bride, Annette Dunham, who was really the only mother that I ever knew. The other mother I'm aware of and conscious of, and I always say I can remember when I came home from the hospital, and just being a newborn. But Annette Dunham was our mother, and we then lived in another suburb of Chicago. It wasn't really a suburb, Joliet, and it's a big town now. Then it was a small town, and that's where I spent my my adolescent years, there in Chicago.
Help me understand how your parents came to marry, because interracial marriages, and particularly that kind of age disparity, is very rare.
Yes, it was very rare. It astonishes me even now. But they did, and they fell deeply in love, married. And that's when my father, I think, probably decided that he could raise a family better in a small town. And I have heard stories, when I was a child, I'd hear stories of how he slept on the property while the house was being built. He slept there in a work shed with a shotgun beside him in order to be sure that there'd be no disturbance and no interruption of his plans or his family life. And we did live, and our neighbors, we had no very close neighbors, but those few that we had seemed to tolerate us, I don't know, but we didn't really need neighbors because we had a full family. My mother brought her family from her first marriage. She brought them to live with us. So I always had half brothers and sisters who were grown and had children who were, some of them were older than I. And this made our big community there in Glen Ellen. We lived there as a very happy, a well-adjusted family until my mother's death. Then, of course, when we had to go and live with our half-brothers and aunts and so on in Chicago, it wasn't easy, because I think that was the very deepest period of what's known as the Depression. A real problem to just get, I think, rent and food money. And that's what I remember from my very young childhood. I remember those years of deprivation, but we were much loved by my Aunt Lulu, my father's sister, and she had a beauty shop in downtown Chicago. Now, this was also very unusual, but with the beginning of the Depression, things were difficult for her. And then began the influx of black people, Negroes from the South, and that made a difference in Chicago. Where beforehand, my father had been welcomed as an apprentice, my Aunt Lulu had been welcomed as a beautician, that was no more the situation. There began to be a real resentment toward these people coming from the South. and taking work and money away from the needy in the city. So I think that was the beginning of a period of real racial tension in Chicago.